And I'm Matt Steele. Today, we're going to introduce you to the Pinnacle Natural Brilliance line of premium car care products.
Now, Pinnacle has a product for every step of the detailing process in your vehicle from top to bottom and inside and out. And Mike, I think it's time that we get started.
Let's do it.
We can come out here and wash the car down. That's one of the most important things we can do is get everything off of the paint, everything off of the wheels, everything off of the car before we bring it in and start the polishing and the waxing. We're actually going to start down here at the wheels and tires. And some of you guys might be wondering, why are we starting there?
The reason you want to start with the wheels and tires is because if you start at the top and wash the body on down, you're going to have standing water in the car. And meanwhile, you're down here washing four wheels and tires. That water could dry and cause water spots. Now you got to go in and remove the water spots.
Right.
So instead, start with the wheels and tires. We're going to use the Pinnacle Clear Coat Safe Wheel Cleaner. And start with the wheels and tires, wash all those first, and then go back and start at the top and work your way down. And as you're washing the car, you can keep on spraying the wheels and tires to keep them wet so water spots don't form on those. But that's why we want to start with the wheels and tires first.
All right, so this is safe for the tires and the wheels right there. And we get a good clean coat on that after we spray it down with water. We just spray it on, and then we can hit it with the brushes.
Yep, you want to start by blasting it like we did first to just knock off any of the loose stuff. Now, this is a utility brush for the tires. We'll tackle that first. When we get to the rims, these are clear coated rims. So just like the clear coat paint on your car, you want to use something that's soft and gentle to it. This is a boar's hair wheel brush. So we're going to take this, and Matt will use this to clean the face of the wheels.
All right, tires are good. You want that?
Yeah, I'll take that. Now, the Pinnacle Clear Coat Safe Wheel Cleaner is non-acid, so it's safe for any wheel. And that's important because a lot of times it's hard to tell if you got a clear coated wheel or a polished aluminum wheel. And if you use the wrong wheel cleaner, you're going to do a lot of damage really fast. And a lot of the times it's actually cheaper just to replace the wheel than to try to undo the damage. Now, this wheel cleaner uses non-ionic surfactant technology with wetting agents and emulsifiers. And here's what that means. When you have a dirty wheel, you've got two things on there. You've got brake dust building up, and you've got road grime. Now, the road grime is kind of oily, so this wheel cleaner is going to go in there and break up the oil so it'll rinse off, and it's going to get the brake, it's going to loosen the bond the brake dust has on the rims so it'll wash off. And that's how this works. It's also water-based, and there's no petroleum distillates.
Let me see that lug nut cleaner right there.
And this is something kind of cool. This is a lug nut brush. Check this out.
It goes right in, and we can get right in that hole. And that's going to be a lot easier than trying to get your finger in there with a rag, you know, and sneak around there and bang your fingers all up.
Well, you get the lug nut, and then you get the barrel where the lug nut goes into. You get that whole thing clean, so the whole thing is a nice uniform clean look to it.
Yep, that looks nice.
And then before it dries, take your water hose and give it a strong blast. Rinse off all that brake dust and road grime.
Now that we've got the wheels and tires all clean, we can start attacking the rest of the vehicle and start washing it from top down. And we're going to do that with a kind of a bucket on bucket idea. Now keep in mind, these clear coats on these vehicles are very scratch sensitive, so you want to use the highest quality products that you can find.
That's right. We're going to show you some cool tips and some techniques for washing your car, but the first thing you want to do is you want to start out with the high quality car wash shampoo. Now this is the Pinnacle Body Works shampoo. This is non-detergent. That's important because if you just use dish soap, you're going to end up stripping off all the previously applied coats of wax. It's also going to dull the paint and dry out other surfaces. Yep. So stick with a wash that's specifically made for clear coat finishes.
Then, of course, another good idea is to make sure that you're not using a rag with a bunch of grit and dirt on it, right, when you're wiping down the car.
That's right. So what I got here is these are natural sheepskin wash mitts,
yep,
really soft, real gentle to the paint. And this is the Pinnacle two-bucket wash system. Now, what we've done here is we've went ahead and applied the Bodywork shampoo to one bucket. This bucket just has clean, clear, rinse water. And the way this works is you take your wash mitt and you start out gathering up some soapy solution. You're going to wash a panel real carefully. You never want to sit here and scrub one place. Usually only takes one or two passes over each section to loosen the dirt to the point you can rinse it off. So don't make the mistake of scrubbing the paint. Now, instead of taking all the dirt you loosened on your mitt and putting it back into your soap solution,
right,
you want to take and put it down inside your rinse solution. And what we have down there is these cool grit guard inserts. And here's how this works. You actually put your hand down there and you rub your mitt across the grill, and what happens is the dirt's going to come off your mitt fall past the grill and is going to get trapped on the bottom of your bucket. And the benefit to that is now you're not just going to take that dirt, take it off one panel, transfer it to another panel, and start rubbing it in, causing swirls and scratches.
So you're rinsing it on this side, soap it back up on this side, and it's back to the vehicle perfectly clean.
Exactly. And a lot of times after you rinse your mitt off, of course it's going to be filled full of clean water. So what you want to do is kind of wring some of that out, and that'll enable you to grab some soapy water to start washing.
All right, so now we're ready to spray it down, right?
Let's do it. You rinse up all the loose dirt.
This is kind of the fun part, too. I'm not going to lie.
You get the fireman's nozzle. That's cool.
You might want to stand back.
I'm going to stand back. I've washed cars with you. I seem to get more wet than the car.
You've got to have a clean car washer as well, Mike. It's very important. You're cleaning the car, you got to clean the individual.
That's right. You want to be clean. This is all about cleanliness.
I think we're soaked down pretty good.
Okay, here's a mitt for you.
Thank you.
Here's one for me. So let's knock this out. Gather some soapy solution.
Where are you going so I can stay out of your way?
I'm going to go up here to the roof. We're going to start at the top and work our way down.
All right, maybe I'll meet you up here.
And again, just one or two passes over each square inch. Loosen the dirt so you can rinse it off. Walk over here and get the other side. Pull the wiper blades
out. I got this half pretty good.
And it's a good idea, if you can, to always wash in the shade, okay? If you're out in the sun, the sun's going to try to dry that soap suds on the car, so we've waited till the end of the day when the sun has gone down, so we're working in the nice, cool shade. Okay, now that we're done washing, I'm going to go ahead and give it a final rinse. Get all those soap suds off there.
What you think?
That looks pretty good. I see a little bit of suds there in the rearview mirror.
Oh yeah, they keep coming.
They always hang
back
up there.
There we go. We'll get them.
Okay, then after we get it all rinsed off, the next thing you want to do is you want to dry it quick before the water spots start to happen. So let's grab some chamois and take care of that. Okay, so what we're gonna use next is called the Guzzler. This is a waffle weave microfiber drying towel. It's very soft and plush, so it won't scratch the paint, but it's gonna just guzzle the water right off the car. Once you tackle the front, I'll start on the roof.
I got it.
So that's one way to get the water off the car, and that's to wipe it. But let me show you another really cool tip. This is called the Guzzler HD. HD stands for heavy duty. This has an inner foam core, and what you can do with this is instead of wiping, if you've got that ultimate show car finish, what you can do is just come down, press this against the paint, and blot that water off. And it holds a lot of water, and it wrings out real easily. When you're done, just throw it in the wash machine, use it again.
All right, Mike, the body's dry. All I need to do now is dry off these wheels and tires, so.
And here's a little tip.
Nice.
Dedicate a towel or your towels just for wheels and tires. That way, just in case any kind of brake particle gets onto the towel, you don't want to use that towel on the paint. So these are actually black microfiber towels. So they're still real soft and gentle because, again, this is a clear-coated finish on the rim there. But he's dedicated his tire by using a black microfiber. So every time he washes it, it comes out of the washer dryer, he knows to only use this on wheels and tires.
Now we're ready to pull this thing in, right?
Yep, let's pull it in and let's get it ready. Start buffing it out, put a coat of wax on it.
Let's do it. Now that we've got both of the vehicles washed and dried, Mike, we're ready to take it to the next step, which is to examine it a little bit closer and really figure out which Pinnacle product we're going to need to use next.
Yeah, what we want to do now is we want to diagnose the paint. We want to inspect it to see what's wrong, because that's going to help us determine which products we're going to use for the next step. So what we want to do first is we want to look for swirls, scratches, oxidation, water spots. Now, there's a couple ways to do this. You can use bright overhead sun, or in case it's not sunny out, this is a really cool tool. This is called the Swirl Finder Light, and it acts like the sun light you can hold in your hand. What you do is you hold this about a foot and a half over the paint, then just kind of slowly move over the paint, and what you're doing is you're looking for swirls and scratches.
There's a lot of them that you can see when you put the light on there, too, that you can't see with the naked eye. You know, 95% of the population will look at that after it's washed and dried and go, hey, it's good enough for me. Let's take it out and party with this car, right?
That's right.
But you can get it a lot cleaner and a lot better looking, which leads to the other way that you can check it, too, and that's simply to touch it and feel it. Now, if you take a look over here, this car's a little bit older. It's beautiful. Now, this is a nice one. We need to talk to this guy because I want to take it for a ride. But if you gently touch it right there, you can feel some bumps here and there, all right? But another idea right there to really get a sense of it is to do what we call the plastic bag test. If you didn't really feel that many bumps, now you do this, and you've got it inside the plastic bag, and real light, you just go over it. Now you can really feel it on this one. You can feel that this has a lot of contaminants in the paint, and it almost feels like a sheet of sandpaper.
Yeah. What the plastic film does is it actually intensifies your sense of touch, and it'll reveal to you contaminants that you might not feel with just your bare hand. And so using that baggy test is going to give you a really accurate assessment of whether you need to clay the paint or if you're ready to just go on to the next step. Now, when we felt this car, it actually, like you're saying, it feels like sandpaper.
Right.
And although it looks really nice, this is an older restoration, so it's probably been a daily driver parked outside. And again, anything in the air that lands on it, if you don't get a wash off right away, it's actually going to bond to the paint, and now you're going to have to use detailing clay to get it off.
Now, the Camaro is a lot newer. It doesn't feel like there's near as many contaminants in the paint, but there is a little bit in there, right? So we need to take these in there and dress them up a little bit. I would say it like this. If these two cars were at the emergency room, this one's going in first.
Yeah, this one, although it feels pretty good, it does need just some light clay just to really get it back to where it's smooth and clean and ready to polish.
Yep. Now, this is the Pinnacle Ultra Poly Clay. It's an ultra fine clay. It's safe for frequent use, but the best part is it's also strong enough to handle a neglected surface like this, one that's got a little bit of junk in it like we were talking about earlier. And the clay is really the secret to bringing this finish back and making it look great again.
Yeah, I think we'd all agree that a great looking finish is a glossy looking finish.
Absolutely.
Gloss comes from smoothness. And if you've got bond contaminants on the paint, that creates surface texture. It diminishes the gloss. So the first step in restoring a glossy finish is to clay the paint.
Now, interestingly enough, when you pull the clay out of the package, there's a couple of things to keep in mind as far as getting it ready for the application. And Mike, you're kind of the worldwide expert on this, and there are a couple of good tips for people, especially if they've done it before or if they haven't.
Well, one of the things you want to do, when it comes out of the box, it's actually like in a little bar, like a bar of soap. What you want to do is you want to take and knead it and make a little patty like this. It'll fit across all four of your fingers, and then here's a little bit of a tip. What you want to do is, a lot of people, when they go to clay, they'll put their hand right on the clay patty like this, and what happens is you'll take and push a hole through the clay with your four fingers, and you got to stop, re-knead, start over again. So take and put your fingertips just past the edge of the clay without thinking about it. You'll put equal pressure over the face of your fingers, and then you decide when you want to re-knead. So.
Now, the key is using the right lubricant right there, and it's the Pinnacle Natural Brilliance Clay Lubricant, and it's actually chemically formulated to work with the clay. A lot of people will wonder, well, can I just use soap and water? Is that going to work? Well, it doesn't necessarily work at all as good because it could break down the clay. It's going to stick. You want to use the right products for the right job.
It can make the clay stick and, like I said, break down the clay. It's actually to use something that's chemically actually made just for the clay. And this creates a microscopic film on there of high lubricity polishing oil that'll actually help the clay to glide over the surface, you know, as you're removing those contaminants.
Here, I'm gonna let you get started there. So there's that.
Put a little bit of clay lube right on the clay patty, onto the paint. Then you just want to come down here and just rub this back and forth in a straight line, and just use light pressure and let the clay do the work. And when I first started out, I could actually feel this kind of dragging, you know?
Right.
And after a few passes, it's starting to glide effortlessly. And that's a sign to me that I've removed the contaminants in that area. I can move on to a new section.
Now, we said earlier that the Camaro wasn't as bad, not as bumpy, so that's not going to be as tough of a job as this one is, right?
Yeah, so tell you what, I'll take the Camaro. Why don't you finish the Corvette?
I'm not quite sure how that... You're one of the most foremost technicians as far as detailing goes in the world, and you're taking the easy job.
Well, that's how I got to the top.
See, I'm starting to figure this out. Here, you need that?
Yeah, I need a little car lube.
Okay. That's fine, Mike. I'm not going to complain.
How does that feel now, Matt?
This feels perfectly smooth. This is exactly how I wanted it to feel. Like a petal of a rose, if you will.
Right? Like a piece of glass.
It's perfection.
Well, now we're ready for the surface prep step. Right. That's where we're going to remove the swirls and scratches and perfectly prepare the paint for a coat of wax.
All right.
Let's get set up for that. Now we're ready for the surface prep step. When we inspected the paint after washing with the swirl finder light, there were no swirls or scratches, and that's acceptable because this is a brand new Camaro. There shouldn't be. The paint is in what we call excellent condition. So what we want to do next is we want to prepare the paint for wax, and we're going to do that with the Pinnacle Paintwork Cleansing Lotion. Now this is an important step. What this is going to do is it's going to remove any surface impurities, any road grime, any kind of contaminants that are actually in the pores of the paint, and also it's going to remove any previously applied waxes or paint sealants.
Now, some people out there don't fully understand what this step is all about, so naturally they'll just skip it, right? They're like, hey, it looks good enough. This is a very important step because, like Mike said, what it's doing is stripping out all of the impurities, the old wax, everything else, and it's giving you a good foundation for the new wax to go on. So this is actually the step that's going to allow the new wax to do what you want the new wax to do.
It's the bond of the paint. In fact, when you clean the paint using a dedicated paint cleaner like this, it's going to allow the wax to bond better. And what that means is it's going to last longer. And what that means is it's going to protect longer. And that's what we all want when we put a coat of wax on our car.
It's all about the prep work. It's similar to a painting project. You know, you talk to those guys, the pro painters, they'll say, look, it's all about the prep work. You married guys know what I'm talking about. You're taking the wife out for a night on the town, right? And you're saying, honey, you've been up in the bathroom for an hour. What could possibly be taking so long? She's like, I'm working on the foundation. I'm getting it ready. Then she comes out and she's looking beautiful and you're like, I get it now. I completely understand the whole process. That's what it's all about. Same thing with your wife, same thing with the car, right?
Yeah, so you're saying treat your car like a lady?
Or vice versa. I mean, either way is fine.
Yeah. Now, when we clayed it, that just removed the contaminants that were on the paint. So again, this is going to deep clean it. It's a step you don't want to skip. Now, this is called a polishing pad. Mm-hmm. You can get different types of pads for it. This is a wax pad, and since we're applying a polish, this is a little more firm for applying the polish. You can use a normal wax applicator pad if you want to, but the problem with this is you hold this between your hand and your thumb, your fingers and your thumb like that, and actually all you're using is this edge of the pad most of the time. By switching over this, you're going to use the entire face of the pad.
Yeah. Now, the first thing we want to do is prime this pad right here. So we're going to get a little bit of the lotion on here and spread it around. You hold that for 1 second?
You bet.
That way we're not wiping a dry pad on the vehicle. So that would kind of defeat the purpose of what we're trying to do, right?
That's right. Clear coats are scratch sensitive, so anything that touches the paint needs to be gentle and soft.
All right. So now that's primed and ready. So we'll put about a dime size amount right there in the middle. And then I can just spread this around a little bit, and we can get going on a little section right here. So we'll just kind of spread this around. Now, good straight lines right there, back and forth, and that'll be a nice, even application.
How this works is it has rich polishing oils, which provide lubrication, cleaning agents, and microfine fillers. And what this does is it's going to completely clean the surface, and if by chance you have any of those really fine swirls or scratches of the paint, it's going to fill them in and actually create a completely smooth surface for the wax to bond to, and that's going to create your show car finish.
Now we let that dry, and then it comes off just as easy as it went on.
So yeah. You just let this dry to a haze, and then it'll wipe off like mass. It's super easy.
Now, you know where the money is, right? This is what I like, is the payoff. And you take a look at this, and like you said, this paint was in excellent condition, but you can feel it here, and then you rub down here, and what a difference. I mean, already. We're just getting started, and man, what a difference that's making.
Yeah, and it felt good after we clayed it. Okay, we removed the above surface bond of contaminants, but this extra step actually brings that smoothness up to an even higher level.
And if it's doing that on this car, think of what it's going to do on that one.
We're going to make some major gains on the black Corvette. Pinnacle Paintwork Cleansing Lotion can be applied by hand or machine. If you want to apply it by machine and you're starting out with the clean, dry pad, it's a good idea to first take and prime the pad. Just like Matt showed you, That way you're not bringing down a dry spinning pad on a delicate clear coat finish.
I think it's interesting how you always work with the machines, taking the work out of the project, right? I'm starting to see how this goes around here.
There we have that. Okay. Then after you prime the pad, put a few more drops of product on there, and that's your working product. This is a Porter Cable dual action polisher.
Cool.
It's variable speed. What I want to do is put this on a medium speed. That's on the 4 setting. And here's a little tip. Put the cord over your shoulder. That way when you're buffing, you don't drag the cord up and down against the fender. And then all you want to do is just place this down against the paint before you turn it on. That way you won't throw splatter everywhere.
Yeah.
Turn it on, and then again, just like Matt, I'm just going to make slow overlapping passes. We'll let the product dry, then we'll wipe it off. Here's another little tip. Don't lift the polisher off the paint until that pad slows down, or you'll throw splatter all over the place.
I appreciate that. All right, so you, again, wipe this off, nice and easy, just as easy as it went on. Look at that. You can feel it again. Perfect, man.
And the machine takes all the work out of the process.
Now, this, again, was designed for finishes that were already in excellent condition.
Yep.
Think about what we need to do now on that old Corvette that's got the major swirls and scratches in it.
We've got our work cut out for us over there. That's got swirls and scratches, so we're going to switch up to the Pinnacle Advanced Swirl Mover and the Pinnacle Advanced Finishing Polish. We'll show you how to do a two-step to create that show car finish again.
We've got a little bit more work on our hands when it comes back over to this vehicle right here, because like we said earlier, we saw some pretty heavy-duty swirls and scratches in this one, but it's a lot older. It's been subjected to a lot more punishment over the years, so that's going to happen. This is completely understandable.
Yeah, this was restored a few years ago, and of course it's been washed and wiped, and well, on a car show, you know, people always come over and want to touch the paint, so it actually has quite a few swirls and scratches in it. So what we're going to do is a two-step polishing process to remove the swirls and then polish to a high gloss.
Step number one is going to be the advanced swirl remover, and we're going to follow that up with the advanced finishing polish. Now, what's cool about this swirl remover is it's got what they call diminishing abrasives in it, right? That's kind of the technology behind it all. So these abrasives are going to go in there and actually attack the scratches and the swirls and get rid of those, but these abrasive particles are going to break down too. They're going to diminish into nothing. So when it's all said and done, you're just going to wipe those out of here. So it's not like the old days where you're fixing swirls and scratches with, you know, or replacing that with other swirls and scratches.
Yeah, the old-fashioned compounds, you know, back in the old days, they would actually remove the swirls and scratches, but because the abrasives didn't break down, they would just put in a new set of swirls and scratches.
Yeah.
Then you just try to cover those up with the wax, and they would call that a good job. So what we're going to do is much better quality work here.
All right, we're going to do that with the machine polisher right here, too. So I'm going to go ahead and prime this pad.
Okay, so what Matt's using here first is a foam cutting pad. So for the initial pass, we need to actually get in there and pull those deeper swirls and scratches out. So we want something a little bit aggressive. Then when he's finished with that, we're going to switch over to a polishing pad. This is much, much softer. We'll use that with the finishing polish.
Yeah, and again, we don't want to hit the surface with a dry pad, right?
Yep, so you want to, what's called priming your pad, and then place some working product on there.
There.
And this takes all the work out of it.
Sure.
You could do this by hand, but it's just so much easier to just let the machine do the work for you. Notice he's got the cord over his shoulder. Take that.
All right.
Now, when we are working on the Camaro over here, that product is something you want to let dry to a haze before you wipe off, the Pinnacle Paintwork Cleansing Lotion. But for both of these polishes, after you're done applying it, you just go ahead and wipe it off. In fact, it'll wipe off easier if you wipe it off immediately.
Yep.
Look at that. That looks good.
Nothing to it, man. Nothing to it. And it already looks a lot better.
And in most cases, just like Matt was doing, you only need to make 3, 4, maybe 5 passes to pull those scratches out. And once the deeper scratch is out and it looks good, we're actually going to take this to an even higher level by using a less aggressive product with a less aggressive pad. Now that we're finished with the first step, here's that polishing pad, Matt.
All right.
Matt's taken off the cutting pad. We switched over to a much softer pad, and we're going to switch over to a much less aggressive, what's called a finishing polish. And the paint looks phenomenal just after the swirl remover, but this is actually going to take the results to an even higher level.
Yep, and we'll prime this just like we did all the rest of the dry pads, just to get good lubrication on there, right?
Yeah, and you only got to do this the first time you use a pad because it's dry.
We'll get a little bit more on there, give us something to work with, and this car is going to be very happy about this, I think. So let me once again get this up over my shoulder and get this in there and get this all over. Now I can go back and forth with it. You gotta love the machine, right? It'll save your forearms.
Man, it takes all the work out of polishing out your car. So again, you don't need to let this product dry to a haze.
Cool.
So you just wipe it right off. In fact, because of the lubricating oils in there, that actually helps to lubricate the surface as you're wiping. The most important thing is, like Matt's showing there, is always fold your towel 4 ways, and that spreads out the pressure of your hand.
It comes off just as easy as it went on.
Yeah, and it's actually really important because he's removed all the swirls and scratches here now, so the last thing he wants to do is go back in and put some in through, you know, shoddy wiping techniques. So always use really good microfiber towels. Be very careful when you're wiping it off. That looks good.
It's getting there.
Yep. Now that we removed all the swirls and scratches, the next step is put the wax on. Now we're ready for the waxing step. We've polished the paint. We're going to go in and put a coat of wax on that's going to lock in the shine, add some protection, and really this is what it's all about. It's creating that show car look. This is the fun part.
Now when it comes to the waxes, Pinnacle gives us 4 different options, and they start right here with this Liquid Sovereign, which is a great liquid wax, easy to use.
What's cool about a liquid is it's so easy to apply by hand or by machine. In fact, if you're watching, when we were working by machine, we had taken and applied the product right to the face of the pad, and the liquid makes it really easy to do that. It also creates a 3-dimensional shine, adds lots of gloss, and protection that lasts up to 90 days.
Now, another easy method is right here with the liquid spray wax, and this is real nice too. Same kind of basic principles, but you know, you can really do it on the go if you have to.
Yes, and this product here, what's cool about this is a lot of spray waxes have alcohol in them, and what that does is it helps the product to flash and dry off. This has no alcohol, no petroleum distillates, has the highest concentration of carnauba wax, plus synthetic polymers, so you get kind of the best of both worlds, natural and synthetic protection.
Now we can get into the pastes, and that's going to start right here with the Signature Series 2, which is a great wax to use.
The Pinnacle Signature Series 2 uses #1 yellow Brazilian carnauba wax. It's great on all colors, buttery smooth, easy to apply, easy to wipe off.
Then we can take it to the next step up, right? The top of the top, the pinnacle, if you will, and that's the Sovereign right here. And that is great specifically on, let's say, a dark colored car, right? Like the red or black that we've got here today. This is really going to make them look hot.
This wax works exceptional on dark colors like black and red. It creates that sizzling shine that everybody loves. It's also very buttery smooth, wipes on, wipes off, very, very easy. Smell this.
It smells great.
It smells so good.
It is.
And that kind of makes waxing your car fun.
Sure. And it's the Brazilian ivory carnauba wax, which has been taken to a new level, right?
That's right. What they've done is that our chemists have taken the Brazilian #1 yellow carnauba wax and they've refined it even further to remove any impurities, and that's where it gets this white color, this white ivory carnauba wax.
I like it, man. Another thing I like about all of the waxes is the fact that, let's say you've got some some of those black trim pieces, it's not going to turn those white like a lot of waxes will.
A lot of waxes stain it white. Once it happens, it's almost impossible to get it off. Right. These won't stain plastic trim white.
All right, so what are we doing first? The vet?
We're going to work on the vet. That's where we finished off. And tell you what, let's apply the liquid, and we'll show you how to do it by machine.
Sounds good to me. There you go. You might be needing that. Now, keep in mind the same principles apply when applying the wax as they did with the polishes a little bit earlier. So we want to prime the pad and get that nice and good so everything's lubricated right. That way we can get the optimum finish.
And I've turned the speed setting down to a low speed. When Matt was removing the swirls, you need kind of a higher speed because you're trying to take the swirls out of the paint job. When we go to put the liquid wax on, all you're really trying to do is spread out a nice, thin, even coat of wax. You don't need the high speeds. And again, one of the really cool things about this is machine application just takes all the work out of it.
You're a big fan of that, I noticed. There seems to be a resounding theme with
okay,
you.
I primed the pad. I put on a few drops of product. That's my working product.
Right.
And again, never turn this on until the pad is in contact with the paint. Always put the cord over your shoulder. Yep. So it'll look kind of like this. And this tool is so easy to use, especially this one hand.
Yeah.
Isn't that better than doing this?
A lot better.
A lot of times when you're machine applying, the idea is to go over each square inch two or three times.
Now, this is the kind of wax that we need to let sit and dry to a haze, so that'll take a couple of minutes. Let's go ahead and let this dry. We'll shoot back over to the Camaro and take a look at those paste waxes.
Let's do it.
Now we're going to show you two different methods of applying the paste wax. First of all, you've got the old school method, which is what Mike's going to show you right now, by hand. You know, you're in the garage, you're wiping it down, spending time with the automobile,
quality time with your machine. Now, if you want to use a paste wax by hand, let me share a couple tips and techniques to make it easy. A lot of people, this is what they'll do. They'll take their applicator pad, take their wax, dip it in, pull a chunk out. Now they got a chunk of wax on their pad. What are they going to do with that?
Yeah.
Watch this. What you want to do is you want to liquefy the wax while it's still in the jar. And to do that, all you got to do is put your pad against the wax. And then watch, I'm going to spin my hand and I'm going to spin the jar at the same time. And that little bit of friction is going to help the wax to seep into the face of this pad. And that's going to make it spread just like a liquid. So correctly used, a paste wax is applied like a liquid, just like this.
You're kind of like priming the pad right there, basically.
Self-priming.
Yeah.
Then you just want to come down here and just spread this out. And then what I like to do is rub in straight lines, kind of the direction the wind would blow over the car. And this is so buttery smooth. Look how well this spreads out.
Yeah, nice and easy.
And again, since we've already pre-cleaned this with the Pinnacle Paintwork Cleansing Lotion, This paint is just as smooth as can be, so it doesn't really take a lot of effort to get the wax spread out. But you do want to make two or three coats over each square inch, and that's for two reasons. That's going to give you a uniform coating over the entire surface, and when you wipe it off, it's going to give you a uniform appearance.
All right, that looks good, but we know you love the machines, so let's take a look at how we can do this same job only using the machine.
Okay, Matt's right. Let me show you a little secret here. It's always easier to work by machine than by hand. It takes all the work out of it. And if you want to apply a paste wax by machine, watch this. I've placed a microfiber glove on my hand. I'm going to take the Pinnacle Sovereign paste wax and just tip it over and kind of give it a hard knock, tap on a few times.
That's pretty cool.
Wax comes right out of there. Now watch this. Just taking like putting butter on a piece of toast. Just spread a little bit onto the pad. We're priming the pad. You're ready to go to town.
Yeah, we're ready to go. And we'll keep that on that low setting that we had from earlier. Throw the cord over the shoulder, and we're ready to go.
And again, two or three passes over each square inch. Uniform coverage means uniform appearance.
Just about done there, Mike. There we go.
Now, here's a unique feature about the Pinnacle Paste Wax, both the Signature Series 2 and the Sovereign Paste Wax. You don't need to let these dry. after you finish wiping them onto the car or machine applying them, just take a clean microfiber towel and gently wipe it off. And at this point, this car is so polished up that just as an extra precaution, I like to inspect my towel, make sure nothing, no kind of particle dirt has got on there. Lay it down, kind of twist it like that, and then just carefully wipe that off.
That comes off ridiculously easy, too.
It's not like you're fighting it off like those old waxes.
Not at all.
No. So easy, even Matt can do it.
Thanks.
Now we're back at the Corvette. Remember, we left the wax over here to dry to a haze while we were working on the Camaro. Now, on the Camaro, we shared some tips and techniques for carefully wiping off the wax using a microfiber towel by hand. What we're going to do over here is show you how to use a machine to take the wax off.
Sure.
But first, I want to show you how to tell if the wax is completely dried or ready to wipe off, and that's called the swipe test. What you do is you take your clean finger and you make a brisk swipe across this wax section here, and just like this.
That's going to tell us if it's ready, because if it's clear and glossy, the paint is what I'm talking about, which it is, that means the wax is dry and it's ready to come off. If that was all smeared and kind of smudgy looking, that means let this sit and finish drying, right?
That's right. Now, it's a little more time to go by.
Now, like you said, though, in keeping with the theme of the day of making everything easier, we're going to take it off with the machine. So,
what we've done is we put another dry pad on here. This is actually a cutting pad, so it's kind of dense and firm. You need that for taking the wax off. And this is a microfiber bond. It's actually reversible. You can use both sides, and it helps to have a garage buddy to hold the tool. Then I'm just going to come in here and place this on.
Is that what I am today, Mike? Your garage buddy?
Garage buddy.
Yeah.
When I get ready to change oil, I'll call you.
I'm a man of many hats, you know? All right, so I crank this baby back up to 6 because I want the maximum power when I'm taking this wax off.
Yep, for moving wax, you need a little bit of power there.
All right, cord, once again, back up over the shoulder, and we're ready to roll. Oh, look at that difference, man.
See how easy that is?
How nice is this going to look, yeah. Right?
Go ahead and finish.
There, that's got most of it.
Then bring a soft, clean microfiber towel and give what we call the final wipe.
Nice.
Look at that. You know, that looks better than most of the show cars at a car show.
Well, it looks a lot better than it did when it came in here, didn't it?
Yep. And that's just how easy it is. You know, you just want to make sure that you use the right technique for the part you're using. Both these parts can be wiped off by hand or machine. We just wanted to share two different options. You can choose the way you want to wipe your wax off. Now we're ready to add the finishing touches to the tires, and for that we're going to use the Pinnacle Black Onyx Tire Gel.
Nothing looks better than a good-looking tire that is shined up and black. I mean, think about all the effort and time that we put into making the car look this good, the rest of the paint. You've got to match the tires as well. It's like having the right pair of shoes with the outfit, right?
Yeah, I tell you, everything's looking good. We're going to shine up the tires. It'll have a complete look to it.
Now here's a little tip for this, right? We've got our applicator right here, and we've got this little groove by the rim. We want to make sure that we get in there evenly all the way around. So we're gonna put some in here right down the side, right? And I'm gonna run that in just like we're priming the pad, like we've been talking about all day. So that'll get me started when I'm going around, right?
That's right. Just take your finger, spread it across there. That'll help you to get the tire gel over the entire face of the tire.
That'll lay in just like that. Now I'll be applying more here in a second, but that gives you an idea of how we're getting started with it. Look at that.
Pinnacle Black Onyx Tire Gel protects against UV rays. It maintains that factory dark sheen that we all love. It contains no petroleum solvents, it's non-greasy, and it's a non-sling formula, so it won't sling off and get up on the sides of the paint when you drive away.
This is looking great down here, Mike, and it's a nice way to really complement the rest of it. You know, the way I look at it is like this. If we're gonna put all that time into making the paint look good and not do the tires, that's like mowing your grass and not edging the driveway.
Exactly.
I mean, why even bother?
It's the finishing touch.
You've got to complete the package.
Plus, it's water resistant, so it's gonna hold up for a long time. Inclement weather, repeated washing, it's gonna stay.
it's time to show a little attention to the interior of the vehicle, because think about it. All day long, we've been doing exterior, right? Yeah. Who's that for? That's for the women looking at the car that you're trying to attract, or your buddies that you're trying to make a little bit jealous, going, wow, take a look at that car, right?
Impress them.
That's for everybody else. But think about it. Where are you going to spend your time? Inside, right there in the driver's seat. You want this to be clean and comfortable and really kind of tailor-made to your specific wants and desires, right? And that's what this is all about. Man, just bringing that interior up to a level that matches the outside, completing the package, if you will.
Exactly. And just like we did with the surface care on the outside of the car, we're going to show you how to break this into dedicated steps. And it's just like we were showing with the paint care. We want to use good surface prep products to actually clean the leather and the vinyl surfaces. Then we're going to use a dedicated leather conditioner and a dedicated leather protectant to go in and actually add the UV protection, make sure it's going to stay soft and supple, and give it that look that just looks like you want to have a seat and go for a ride.
Mike, I think you bring up a very good point and one that people can oftentimes overlook as well. The same holds true for the wax and everything on the exterior. If you don't prep it right, what good is it, right? Same thing on the inside. If we don't get this good and clean, we can hit it with everything we want to. It's not even going to do the job, man.
And the reason for that is because, well, first of all, this is a convertible, but you still want to do all this in case you got like a coupe over here, like the Camaro.
Right.
But being a convertible, it's exposed to the sun. If you're driving around the sun, you're going to sweat.
Sure.
You have perspiration, which is salt and oil coming off your skin.
Yeah.
Any place your skin touches, the armrest here, the backs of the seats, you're going to be depositing this stuff, and you want to come in here and regularly clean that off with a dedicated cleaner. And that's what I've got here. This is the Pinnacle Leather Vinyl Cleaner. You can use it on both leather and vinyl. Non-silicone. It's non-alkaline, water-based, completely safe for anything. And what I like to show people and use myself is this is a microfiber applicator pad. And this small little microfiber nap actually gives it kind of some gentle scrubbing action
sure.
to really work those oils out.
Yeah, you could go this route right here, but this is going to give it a little bit more traction, right?
Exactly. Notice how I put the head, I just bury it right into the pad. Now I've got overspray over everything. Now I've got my cleaner on here. I just bring this down. And what you want to do is you want to take and you want to work this in. You're trying to lift and bring out any contaminants, any body oils, any dust that accumulates. Just get that all off there.
Yeah, man. I mean, think about it. You could be hauling around pets, kids. Anything could be going on in the interior of this car.
Okay, come over here. Look at, you're always putting your arm against that, aren't you?
Yeah. Get that, you can tell, because that was a little bit messy looking.
Can you hold this?
Yeah, man. Get that out of the way. Get
this. Now, these are leather seats, so we're going to want to use a leather conditioner on these. The door panels are vinyl, so we want to use a dedicated vinyl and rubber protectant on those.
And we've got the dash to contend with as well.
Okay.
All right.
After you work that in, take a clean microfiber towel. You want to wipe off any excess, because in this excess is the grunge you've kind of loosened up. Just come down here and get that all off there. Okay, it already smells cleaner and looks cleaner.
Yeah.
Okay, so now for the leather seats, we're going to use the Pinnacle Leather Conditioner. This is just a rich lotion. Now, I used a little microfiber applicator pad to apply the cleaner, but now I'm going to switch over to foam because I don't really need any scrubbing action. I did that in the prep step. Shake that up. There's a take and put some right on here.
Now, this will actually bring back some of the original characteristics of the leather, right? So you're not masking a smell, or you're not creating a new scent or anything like that. You're actually kind of breathing new life into this old leather. That's the whole concept behind it.
You're bringing out the leather's natural aroma.
Right.
It's lanolin-based and contains conditioning oils, and that's going to turn the leather soft and supple, and that's what you want.
Let me know if you need some more of this.
Okay.
So you've got this completely under control, though. It's about time.
That's right. It's about time I step up the plate and do something here. Go ahead. A little bit more here.
There you go.
There we go. Come down here and get the face of the seat here. And besides protecting, getting it all clean, look how it's making it look.
Yep.
I mean, we want the inside to look as good as the outside now. That looks good.
You're coordinating the entire outfit is what you're doing.
Okay, then after you rub this in really well, get it down into the stitching here. Okay, this is a non-alkaline and no petroleum distillates, and that's important because if you get those kind of chemicals in your dressings, leather or vinyl, it's gonna wear out that stitching, cause it to come apart. So it's one of the cool features about that. No alkalines, no petroleum distillates, no solvents.
It saves you a call to the upholstery guy, because that can be an expensive call at times.
Especially on a car like this.
Right.
Okay, so I'll let that penetrate for a few seconds, and then just come back and just gently wipe off any excess.
I'll get the other one, though.
I'll let you get the other one. Then we'll take it for a ride. Okay, so that's how we take care of the leather. Next, I want to show you how to take care of this vinyl. We're going to use just like we used a dedicated product for the leather, we're going to use a dedicated vinyl and rubber protectant. And again, this is non-silicone, okay? And there's no petroleum distillates. It's water-based, so it's completely safe. Plus, it has that UV protection. And of course, being in a convertible, that's very important because this is exposed to the sun
every
time you take the car out. I'll take another one of the yellow applicator pads.
There you go.
What I like to do with this is like shake it. I always want to shake anything that's been standing for a while. Then again, I'm just going to bury the head of this right into the foam.
Now you're doing that so that you don't have the overspray going on to everything else that you just cleaned, right?
Exactly. Now, I cleaned this right here, the door panel right here, and watch how this is just going to bring that color back.
Yeah, that's going to make things look a lot better because it's looking a little dull right here.
Yeah, dull and weathered.
Yeah, yep.
Watch this.
That Ooh. Looks nice down there, doesn't it?
And this is actually real simple stuff, you know. Anybody can do this. And it's a good idea to actually put your interior on a regular maintenance schedule. You know, so maybe once a month, every other month, come in here, do some cleaning, some protecting.
Remember, this is for you, not for everybody else. Yeah. So that's why it's important.
Let that penetrate for a few seconds, then just come back and wipe any excess off. Now, if you want to make this even simpler, or say you treated it, but you want to come back and just do some touch-up repair, we have an all-in-one product. So it's going to clean, condition, and protect all in one step. This is the Pinnacle Vinyl. Actually, it's this one over here.
Oh.
Leather cleaner and conditioner. Now, you can use this on leather and vinyl. Leather, being a natural material, is a little more finicky than man-made vinyl. So generally, the rule is anything that's safe enough for leather is plenty safe for vinyl. And again, you just want to take and shake this up. I'll take a yellow applicator pad there.
You're going through these things.
Yeah, it's a good idea to have a few of these on stock. And again, I just like to bury that, load some up inside there, and then when I press on the foam, it releases the product. And you can just take and use this, and again, you just want to do a quick one step. We're just going to clean, condition, and protect all in one step. Like up here, here's the handle on the dash. In case Matt's driving too fast, I got something to hold on to.
You probably want more than one handle for that.
I'll put the other hand up here.
Yeah.
Maybe I won't even ride with you.
Could be wise.
But that'll clean, condition, and protect in one step. So it's good to keep that in the trunk or behind the seat in case you have any kind of emergency. You spill some coffee. You have someone ride, they got suntan lotion on the back of their leg, they sit in their seats, they get out, you can see, you can either take a ride off. Then again, clean microfiber towel, just come down, just gently wipe that. And look at that, it leaves a nice, rich satin sheen. It's not glossy, it's not sticky, it looks factory new.
Inside looks great, and it's ready to roll. Kind of matches the outside now.
It's got the complete look going for it now. But that is how you take care of your interior using either your choice, dedicated cleaner, and then followed with a dedicated protection for vinyl or a dedicated protection product for the leather, or use a one-step. Hey, Matt, looks like you missed a spot.
You know you're killing me, right, Mike? Come on now, take it easy.
Hey, you know, I think the results speak for themselves. Just look how these cars glisten.
These are two great examples of what you can do with Pinnacle products. I mean, the Camaro rolled in here in excellent shape. The thing was beautiful, but we've made it look even better. And that's pretty impressive to take something that looked that good and make it better. Right?
Amp it up just a little bit.
Sure.
And what's important is if you have a car that's already new or in good shape, is to take care of it so it doesn't go downhill like the Corvette did.
Right. Now, that was a swirled up mess when it rolled in here, but it's looking great now. That thing is shiny. It's looking wet.
We removed the swirls, we added the wax, created that show car finish, and made it look easy.
Here's another great thing about all the Pinnacle products is they're all USA certified, which means they're made right here in the United States of America. Everything from the bottle to the cap to the label to the ingredients inside, it's all made right here in the USA.
That's right. Hey, I hope these tips and techniques have helped you. If you have any more questions, check out PinnacleWax.com.
You can go right there, order it from the comfort of your own home, and they will ship it right to your door. It couldn't possibly get any easier. And now it's time for you and I to take a ride. Which one you want?
I'll take the Camaro.
I'll take that one.
Let's do it.
That worked out.